No otherwise qualified handicapped individual in the United States shall, solely on the basis of his handicap, be excluded from the participation in, be denied the benefits of, or be subjected to discrimination under any program or activity receiving federal financial assistance. Section 504 of the Rehabilitation Act of 1973. On April 5, 1977, people with disabilities across the nation demonstrated to demand that regulations implementing Section 504 of the Rehabilitation Act be signed into law. The demonstrations spontaneously erupted into sit-ins. In San Francisco, over 100 people made the federal building our home for 26 days.
Some of the demonstrators occupied an area outside the office of HEW Secretary Joseph Califano. When Califano appeared, he praised their cause but said there were problems such as enforcement. However, he promised action.
I will sign a set of 504 regulations by early May.
Now
I will do it
now. Not May, now.
A handicapped demand that Section 504 of the Civil Rights Act be signed. It was passed by Congress in 1974. It guarantees the rights of the handicapped in education and employment. The Ford administration never implemented the act. And now the new HEW Secretary, Joseph Califano, says he will sign it in May. The handicapped want him to sign it now.
Elizabeth, what's going on now is an overnight sit-in. Actually, the demonstration is going on throughout the entire nation, Washington, New York, Denver, here in San Francisco. It all started this morning here at the old federal building on 50 Fulton when an incident took place outside. Immediately after that demonstration this morning, the handicapped started invading the building. It's the old federal building, which is now the HEW headquarters. They spent most of the day in the office of the regional director here.
Gotten word to this, these people are now locked into the building. At 6 o'clock, this building did close down. However, about a half hour ago, they came up with an agreement. None of these people are going to be arrested or moved out of this building. Some members of the HEW staff will be remaining here with them throughout the night. Those people who are here right now will be locked in. If they want to leave, it's all right, but they can't come back in. Food, we hear, is being brought over by Delancey Street. However, the Salvation Army has not been able to come up with blankets or cots, that sort of thing, so they are still frantically out looking for that.
What about the restroom facilities and that sort of thing there? Are they equipped to handle that many handicapped people, and could they get that help?
They absolutely are not equipped to handle them. The regional director asked before 4 o'clock if he could try to get out of this room because he needed to go to the restroom. And the group here said, no, we have had to learn all of our lives to control our bladders, and you must learn that lesson now, too.
There are approximately 75 or more who are taking part in this sit-in. This makes this the largest sit-in in the nation currently going on concerning the disabled and the handicapped. In Washington, there are about 40 people sitting in the outer office of the HEW Secretary, Joe Califano, and there are about 7 people in New York.
98 people stayed overnight in the offices used by regional HEW Director Joe Maldonado. The 50 who remain at this hour say they have no intention of leaving until...
There are people that want to stay here until, and there is a significant number of those people.
Quite frankly, I think it's going to be very difficult for them to put a lot of pressure on us. When we asked them questions yesterday about 504, and we said to them, have you ever read 504? Every one of the people that we had in that office said no. I mean, I think that they should thank us for being here and welcome the opportunity that finally they're going to get educated about the law that they're supposed to be enforcing.
Disabled and handicapped spent the second night of the sit-in in a string of offices on the fourth floor of the building. HEW officials are stiffening their easy attitude about the demonstrators. All outside phone lines, except one emergency line, have been cut off.
Incoming calls, however, are still coming through. Food still is being delivered into the building, but demonstrators no longer can enter. If they leave the building, well, they just stay out.
By now, this demonstration here in San Francisco is clearly symbolic. The group which left the Washington, D.C. offices of HEW yesterday afternoon were the only ones who really had direct access to Secretary Joseph Califano. Any demonstration here in San Francisco, well, can only be to show support, but it can't do anything tangible to get that anti-discrimination law signed right now.
They're tired, they're grubby, they're uncomfortable, but their spirits are soaring. The sit-in at San Francisco's HEW headquarters now is in its third day, and 125 disabled and handicapped are pledging they'll continue the sit-in through tomorrow night, if not longer. The squeeze is on, though. Hot water has been turned off on the fourth floor, where the Occupation Army of Cripples has taken over.
The demonstration here is now on its fourth day. It is by far the largest and longest protest ever organized by disabled people in this area. But the problem on this, the fourth day, is still the same as it was on Tuesday, trying to get the attention of the Washington.
One thing, it's the first really militant thing that disabled people have ever done. And we feel like we're building a real social movement. And we want people to listen to us. We have tried negotiations, they do not work, and at this point, we are non-negotiable. We want those regulations signed.
Their cause has drawn the support of rank and file HEW workers, labor unions, church groups, farm workers, the Gray and Black Panthers, California legislators, and the governor.
He might be the mayor of San Francisco, but it wasn't enough for George Moscone and other city officials on federal turf today. They came to the HEW offices to endorse and assist the handicapped. But the federal officials drew the line when it came to installing a device which converts a sink into a makeshift shower. And that's where the mayor and his delegation discovered the limits of their authority.
Thank you for trying anyhow. All right, Jeff.
The shower's on or off, Mayor? The shower's on or off.
We can't give any permission for the showers.
What was his reasoning?
He's not running a hotel.
With one unified voice, the disabled of California said today, we have waited long enough. And with that, the rally outside the old federal building, which houses the HEW offices, reached a climax. The physical support was impressive and offered the mental and vocal backing that those inside really needed. It is nearing 2 weeks now since 150 handicapped people moved into the HEW offices, and it was today, in response to that occupation, that a special congressional hearing convened.
Could you help him Xerox a copy of that right now, please?
I think one of the things that Secretary Califano and his representatives who we've been negotiating with since they came into office forget is that when they sit around and intellectualize about what started off as 8 issues, then it escalated to 15 issues, then it went up to 18, then it went up to 25, and God knows where it's going to go next, is that while they sit around and think about how they're going to enforce regulations, that they don't seem to understand our lives are not changed, our civil rights are not granted. And I personally react to that. That's my civil rights they're messing around with.
And I found, and millions of other people with disabilities are finding, that access, that my ability to move around, and that my ability to regain the pride in myself as a person with a disability is one of the most important things that's coming out of what's happening here today. And to see hundreds of people with disabilities rolling, signing, using canes, the more severely retarded people for the first time joining us in this incredible struggle is one that leads me to believe that we're going to win this. We're down to the bottom line, down to the basic issue here. Are we going to perpetuate segregation in our society. We're one of the largest minorities in this country. I looked at the 18 points that HEW put out this morning. I have never seen a better blueprint for segregation. These kinds of issues, the issue of civil rights, of human rights, are not one issues that people with disabilities can compromise any further.
If they had to choose the most important part of these regulations to eliminate and to reconsider, they chose them. So I resent the fact that they say we're in fundamental agreement. We're not in fundamental agreement. We're in fundamental disagreement.
Whether there was a Section 504, whether there was a PL 94-142, there was a Brown versus Board of Education. The harassment, the lack of equity that has been provided for disabled individuals and that now is even being discussed by the administration is so intolerable that I can't quite put it into words. I can tell you that every time you raise issues of separate but equal, the outrage of disabled individuals across this country is going to continue. It is going to be ignited. There will be more takeovers of buildings until finally maybe you begin to understand our position. We will no longer allow the government to oppress disabled individuals. We want the law enforced. We want no more segregation. We will accept no more discussion of segregation. And I would appreciate it if you would stop shaking your head in agreement when I don't think you understand what we are talking about.
Afternoon put the final touches on their next plan of action. They're taking their protest to the source. 14 handicapped demonstrators and 8 attendants will fly tomorrow to Washington, where they hope to see President Carter himself, or at least tell HEW Secretary Joseph Califano themselves how they feel.
It was sweltering, hot, but they went to HEW anyway, staying in the streets when the curbs stopped them. They were trying to force a meeting with Califano after he had canceled one scheduled earlier, but they were blocked.
I felt like I was being excluded from a building that I pay taxes to keep open, and I am absolutely mortified that President Carter is allowing this to go on. His open door policy certainly is not very open, and to have these big 6-foot, 7-foot cops standing there with people my size is the most ludicrous thing that I have ever been involved in.
Back in Washington today, more than 100 people marched in front of the White House. The demonstrators would be content if Carter would only put pressure on the HEW director, Califano, to sign the civil rights bill guaranteeing the rights of handicapped people, but it doesn't look as if Carter will even do that. It looks even less promising for Carter to see the demonstrators personally, even though they've traveled there from San Francisco for that very purpose. And in the meantime, the group of handicapped people are sticking to their guns here in San Francisco. Today starts the third week of their sit-in at the old federal building.
San Francisco is kind of a special and unique place. After all, it's the only place in the country where the blind and the deaf and the arthritic and the retarded and the para and the quadriplegic, those with cerebral palsy and muscular dystrophy, can get it together enough to journey 6,000 miles to fight for their civil rights. They came home tired tonight, but they're justifiably, I think, quite proud of their trip.
Good evening. 35 million Americans, handicapped Americans, won a big victory today when HEW Secretary Joseph Califano signed the paper today. The implementation of the law began.
But
but I discovered something about myself that I didn't know, that I counted as a person, and through 504, I now have more of a chance to count, and I just really feel fantastic.
This is a beginning. It's a huge, tremendous beginning. It's really a leap forward for us.
The signing of the regulations signified the public birth of the disability rights movement. It ushered in an era of disability activism, empowerment, and legislative victories based on the legal concepts of non-discrimination and integration embodied in Section 504.